Now, one of the questions we're asked a lot is, what should I bring to the hospital? Well, truthfully, you won't need much while you're here. We ask that you bring a pair of non-skid shoes, something sturdy for those first steps after surgery. Also, go ahead and bring your personal items like glasses, dentures, and hearing aids if you have them. We've got plenty of basic cosmetics like shampoo and toothpaste, so no need to bring those. Please make a list of your current medications with doses and times that you take them. Be sure to include vitamins and herbal supplements too. Bring inhalers if you have them, but don't bring your actual medications. We'll take care of distributing those here. You'll also want to pack your insurance cards and some loose pull-on clothing to wear home. If you already have a walker or other adaptive equipment, go ahead and bring those too. We'll want to make sure they fit you properly and that they're in good working condition. Now remember, please don't bring your medications other than your inhalers. We also recommend that you leave behind large amounts of money, credit cards, jewelry, or expensive skincare products. We do a few things a little bit differently here at Mercy Hospital, starting with your accommodations. Each of our overnight patients recovers in a private room along with a private bathroom. There's even Wi-Fi and a flat-screen TV. Your family's more than welcome to spend the night with you, but keep in mind that we also offer discounts to local hotels. Another option to consider is Gary's House. This home-like setting is part of the Mercy family and offers a variety of lodging options for a nominal fee. Instead of the traditional meal structure, we offer room service. This means you can order off our menu on your schedule, just like staying in a hotel, except there's no additional cost. And this service is also available for your family members for a small charge. Okay, I think that does it. The planning phase is over, and now it's the day before your surgery, a very significant day. And here to tell us why is Dottie Dyer, one of the nurses here at the Orthopaedic Institute at Mercy Hospital. Welcome, Dottie.
Thank you, Linda.
So tell us, why is the day before surgery so important?
Well, it helps to prepare your body for surgery.
What are some of the things that folks should remember?
The day of surgery, you should avoid tub baths, shaving your legs. You should shower the night before and the morning of using an antibacterial soap like HippoCleanse or chlorhexidine, which your physician's office will supply for you. You should follow your eating instructions so you'll know when to stop eating and when to stop drinking. Also, know what medications you can and can't take.
Great, Dottie. The day has arrived. Their bag is packed. They have just followed all of your instructions. Can you tell folks what happens next?
Sure. The Mercy Orthopaedic Institute is located at our new Four River campus, right off 295 in Portland. Come on into the hospital and stop by the front desk. From there, you'll be given directions to the second floor ambulatory care unit, where a nurse will check you in. This is when you'll change out of your street clothes, be administered an IV, and meet with your anesthesiologist to discuss your options and preferences. We'll also secure all of your belongings, which will be delivered to your room after surgery. Your joint replacement procedure will last anywhere from 1 to 3 hours, followed by time in the post-anesthesia care unit with our recovery staff. During your procedure, your family can wait in the surgical waiting area where they can monitor your progress on our patient tracking board. And when your surgery is complete, they'll meet privately with your surgeon for a full rundown. Then after recovery, we'll take you back to your room where you'll be reunited with your family and your belongings.
Now, Dottie, I know when folks wake up from surgery, they may be surprised by some of the equipment and machines that they're interacting with. Can you tell us a little bit about what they might expect?
Sure. They are hooked up to quite a few things that can be a little scary if you don't understand what they're for. First of all, I'd like to show this cryo cuff. Mm-hmm. It's filled with ice water. It's for our total knee replacement patients. And this is a cuff that goes right around the knee. And that helps to prevent swelling, and it actually helps with the pain. So that's a very important piece of equipment. The other thing, this is called a sequential compression device, or SCD, as you're going to hear the nurses call it. And this is tubing that's hooked right to a machine at the edge of the bed. This cuff goes around the leg, and it very gently massages the blood back up to the heart and helps to prevent blood clots, which is very, very important.
How about this?
This is a drain that we use, or I should say the doctors use, to help pull away excess blood and fluid from the either knee or hip. Not all patients have this, but if your doctor feels it's necessary, you will come out of surgery with it. It fills very slowly with fluid from your knee, and it's excess fluid that helps also with the swelling. It keeps that swelling down.
Right. Now, I know that there are other pieces of equipment that may not be here. Can you tell us what those might be?
Yes. You hooked up with an IV, with IV fluids. Mm-hmm. You have probably oxygen in your nose. That just helps with your oxygen. Also, you could have an oxygen monitor, just a little probe on your finger. And a cardiac monitor could also be applied. But just know, this is all very normal and things that you're going to be hooked up to.
Great. Thanks, Dottie. This is some good information.
You're welcome.